Tennessee, Chris. From Gainesville, Georgia, Crystal Rose. And her opponent.
Oh, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ladies are in action right now on NWA Anarchy. Greg Hunter and Andrew Alexander back with you, fans. It is Crystal Rose right now with the side headlock, albeit not for long, on Melissa Coates. And Andrew, what about that sit-down interview we just saw at season's meetings? Win, lose, or draw, Todd Sexton's done.
That's shocking news, but can you really be that shocked? I mean, he's going up against Jeremy Bain. One match with Jeremy Bain, he knows what's going to happen, so he's just going to take the easy way out and just announce that he's leaving the sport of professional wrestling. But he's going to be forced to leave the sport of professional wrestling when Jeremy Bain is done with Todd Sexton.
Well, no doubt, the excellence of sexecution. Todd Sexton will have a tall test ahead of him against the former Anarchy heavyweight champion, the untouchable Jeremy Bain. And we will see, oh, wait a minute here, cover, only a one count. We will see both of those men in action next week on this very telecast as Jeremy Bain will team up with the number one contender to the Anarchy title, Orion Bishop, to take on the team of Todd Sexton and the Anarchy heavyweight champion, Shadow Jackson.
Huge tag team main event. That's going to be on next week's show. But on this week's show right now, we're seeing a rare appearance by women in Anarchy of returning to the ring, Melissa Coates, who's had a huge fall from grace, going from kissing Brody Ray Chase to kissing some five-year-old in the front row here, some snot-nosed brat against Crystal Rose, a Cornelia, Georgia native, a huge fan following in the crowd tonight. Both of these women very popular.
Neither one of them a stranger to the rings here at NWA Anarchy, as we are just a few weeks away from season's beatings. And right now, Crystal Rose with an armbar applied to Melissa Coates. Smart maneuver. You take away an arm, you take away part of the strength of the former Miss Olympia.
You can easily, even though Melissa Coates is obviously stronger than a competitor, she can easily break her arm right now with this cross armbar. But Melissa Coates, see, there's the power I was just talking about, powering out of it, dropping her on the back of the neck. She had no choice but to let go of that maneuver.
Folks, season's beatings is shaping up. We know that we will see Jeremy Bain against Todd Sexton in Todd Sexton's final match. We also know now that the Anarchy Tag Team Championship will be on the line. It will be the champions, Talent and Money, defending against Ace Rockwell and Truett Fields. Oh, gorilla press slam here out of Melissa Coates. She's got Crystal Rose high overhead. Good Lord.
I want to know why Ace Rockwell and Truett Fields become the number one contenders out of nowhere. They've been a tag team for a total of 1 month. They've beaten no one in tag team action, and now you're going to sit there and tell me that they're going to leapfrog the entourage and become number one contenders to those tag team titles?
A cover there by Melissa Coates and only a two count. One could argue, Andrew, that...
One could argue that no one is paying attention when I come out here every week and say repeatedly that the entourage, myself, the Hollywood Hacksaw, Andrew Alexander, and Mike Mosley are the next tag team champions.
One could also argue that by our tag team champions simply standing in the ring and demanding we want competition, that it was an open challenge.
So you're telling me because I was a professional and I sit here in this booth with you and I didn't get up and go to the ring myself, which I could have done, because I was a professional, I'm no longer in contention for those tag team titles. Ace Rockwell and Truett Fields. They're the number one contenders. That's what you're sitting there telling me?
Well, they took the advantage of an open opportunity, it would seem. Right now, Melissa Coach just overpowering Crystal Rose here.
And Captain Obvious strikes again. Of course she's overpowering. Look at her. She's got the most most impressive physique I've ever seen on a woman in a muscular way. I mean, I've seen some good-looking women in my day.
All right. Oh, Melissa Coates ends up going down throat first, and now back to the arm.
You got to give it up to Crystal Rose. She's coming in this match. She has a game plan, obviously. She's trying to attack. I don't know if she has some sort of knowledge that we don't, some sort of injury that Melissa Coates has had on that left arm, but she's going for it, and she's not letting up.
Folks, still to come, we will see Falls Count Anywhere. The Hate Junkies, the team of Strychnine and Danny Only, they will take on the Rowdy Friends, Merciless Don Matthews, and the Hellbilly Jesco Blue. And still to come, folks, the National Heavyweight Champion, the Universal Soldier Shatter in action. He will take on B.J. Hancock one-on-one this week on Anarchy. And Melissa Coates saying she's done. And right now, setting up Crystal Rose. Implant face breaker. She very well could be done.
That
cover.
Has to be it. And three.
Let's go to Michael Gentry for the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Melissa Coates.
Melissa Coates picks up the win this week on NWA Anarchy. But picking up moment by moment.
She's a bridge house. That lady's trapped. That's a fact. Ain't holding nothing back. Oh, she's a bridge house. We're all put together. Everybody knows this is how the story goes.